Friends, family, those of you watching right now, this has been well over a year in the making, and so let's get this couple married, shall we? We are gathered here this afternoon before God in order to celebrate the covenant union of Sean and Amy. Would you bow your heads with me in prayer? God, we come before you this afternoon with great joy to witness these two lives which you are joining together. We rejoice that not only do you show us love, not only do you give us people who love us, but you yourself are love. And so we are humbled that you have loved us first. God, we love because you first loved us. So here in this place, we are witnesses to a man and a woman publicly declaring their love for one another, entering into the sacred union of marriage that you instituted at the creation of the world. God, we are excited to see how you will lead Sean and Amy as one flesh from this day onwards. We pray for your blessings upon their life as a married couple, as well as your blessings upon our ceremony right now. During this time, may we know and be reminded of your very presence here in this place and in their lives. Lord, may you be pleased in all of this. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay. Right now, I'm going to read from Paul's epistle to the Ephesians. This is Ephesians chapter 5, verses 22 to 33. And this is what the Lord's word says. Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and is himself its Savior. Now, as the church submits itself to Christ, so also wives should submit in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, that he might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, so that he might present the church to himself in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish. In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself, for no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it just as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. This mystery is profound, and I am saying that it refers to Christ and the church. However, let each one of you love his wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. So today I have a short message for Sean and Amy. Sean and Amy, this is a special day for you, a very, very special day, something that has been so anticipated much longer than you would have expected, but the biggest reason this day is so special is this: God has called you to be one. Some of your family and friends are here, many are witnessing this online, and we are all so very excited for you. Sean and Amy, as you guys are both Christians, your marriage must be a Christian marriage, one that has the glory of God as its aim, the exaltation of Christ as its center, and the sanctifying work of the Holy Spirit as its power. So as we heard from the scripture reading earlier, Paul's teaching on marriage is like the mystery of Christ and his church. You must always understand and remember that the cross of Jesus Christ needs to be the center of your lives, both individually and as a married couple. A Christian marriage is about dying to oneself, because that is what Christ did for his bride. Ephesians 5:25 says, "Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her." Now likewise, verse 22 says, "Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord." All in all, marriage is not about control, it's not about power. It is about the gospel. It's not about who wins or loses an argument. It is not about who's better or who's worse, because you know that at the foot of the cross, while you are equally sinful, you are also equally loved. in the eyes of the Lord. And that sort of love should shine forth in the way you treat one another. So Sean, in loving Amy the way that Christ loved the church, you are demonstrating, at least in part, the sacrificial love that Christ displayed for our sake. Always make sure that you are lovingly and patiently leading her. Amy, in submitting to Sean as to the Lord, you are demonstrating, at least in part, the submission that Christ himself demonstrated in coming to earth and going to the cross. As Paul wrote in Philippians, we are to consider the example of Christ, who though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but instead emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men, humbling himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. And so in your duties to one another as a married couple, the both of you are displaying the gospel of Jesus Christ to one another and also to those around you. So today, as you two join in marriage, no longer will you only be two individuals, you will be one flesh. From here on out, the two of you shall also become one flesh. Today marks the end of your lives as single people and begins your new life together as a married couple. This is just a sweet beginning of a joyful journey of denying yourself and giving over not only all that you have, but all that you are to one another. And so, as Christians, Christ is to be our example in all things. This is what Christ did for us on the cross. And so, you two, on this long-awaited day, I challenge you to raise the cross over your lives. Now, with that, let us pray. Father, we thank you for teaching us about love in the Bible. That your word teaches us how to love one another. May your words ever be with Sean and Amy as they begin this new and exciting chapter of their lives together. May your word shape and mold their lives. May your Holy Spirit lead them along. Lord, Holy Spirit, be intertwined in their lives in every way. Jesus, we thank you for all that you have already done on the cross in giving us our salvation. We praise you, Father, for what we are witnessing today. And may Sean and Amy's marriage be an example of your word come to life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now may I have the rings, please. So these rings are the coordinating sign of your covenant before God. They are made out of precious metals to symbolize that your covenant is precious. They are rings to symbolize that there is no end, as there will be no end to your love for one another. And so, here you go, Sean. Okay. Turn towards one another and look into each other's eyes. Sean Hui, before God and man, do you take Amy to be your wife, to live together as God has ordained in holy matrimony? Will you love her, cherish her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Answer, I do.
I do.
I'll take the flower.
Okay, Amy, repeat after me. No, don't repeat after me. Amy Zhang, before God and man, do you take Sean to be your husband, to live together as God has ordained in holy matrimony? Will you love him, obey him, honor and protect him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Answer, I do.
I do.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. Now, by the authority vested in me by the New Testament Church and honored by the state of New York, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Sean, you may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you.
Good afternoon. Thanks for stopping by. We love you, and yeah, we'll have a edited video for you guys to view later later next week.
Thank you for attending. We love you guys.
For some cake.
Huh?
我们马上带下来吧。
Oh, I'll go get a ring, let the choir bells sing like ooh.
Don't cover your Okay. This is the cover. Oopsie.
Real to real in the way I feel. I could walk you down the aisle.
I wanna do you like Michael. I wanna
Falling in angel. Who says you can't be in movies? Listen to me, listen to me. Who says you don't pass the test? Who says you can't be the best? Who said, who said? Would you tell me who said?